Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath. Thanks for coming back. I appreciate you watching my videos. I've created for people just like you that just want a bit of information, not too complicated, common sense stuff. So I hope this is a good video for you regarding, you know, one of the aspects of gut inflammation I'm talking about. Be sure to watch the other videos in this series on gut inflammation. So right now we're going to talk about the signs and symptoms of gut inflammation. But to start with, what's the difference between a sign and a symptom? You might have heard of those words before. Well, a symptom is subjective. It's what you feel, not what the doctor feels. It's what you feel. You're experiencing this symptom, right? Sometimes the doctor won't believe that you've got a symptom, right? But you know you've got the symptom. A sign is objective. The doctor can see it or test it or measure it or experience it for him or herself, you know, through seeing some kind of objective, evidence that symptom really is there. So that's symptoms and signs. So let's look at the symptoms first. Actually, let's look at the signs first. So a doctor's going to say, yes, you've got some inflammation. They'll actually find it through a blood test. So most doctors like to look at different markers in the blood. There's one called C-reactive protein. Excuse me. There's also HS, or high sensitivity C-reactive protein. That tends to determine more for heart disease. But CRP levels in general a quite good indication, you know, on where your body's at with an inflamed response. Now, you could have an inflamed gut and have no CRP elevation at all. That's the other problem. So there are various other blood markers I won't go into at the moment. There's ESR and markers like that. So, you know, there are ways of picking up signs if there's systemic inflammation, but systemic is not necessarily gut inflammation. The doctor could also do other tests, including stool tests, right? And then they will pick up inflammatory markers if they're there, particularly if it's a high-grade inflammation. And these are markers I've spoken about in previous videos, like calprotectin and lysozyme. And these are specific markers. They're like either proteins or enzymes secreted by white blood cells in the gut that could show you if there's a degree of inflammation or not going on. So there are ways to determine that. And many people I find have low-grade inflammation in their gut. I would say about 60 to 70% have got not necessarily overt or high inflammation, but low-grade inflammation. So their result will be very close to the borderline. And it's actually more common than you think. So let's look at the symptoms now, or the things that you're experiencing, right, that you feel when you've got when you've got a problem there with an inflamed gut. I made a little list here of different things. So some of the common ones, irritable bowel syndrome kind of symptoms like gas, bloating, irregular bowel motions. So inflammation doesn't always have to signify pain. Inflammation can also be in terms of gas or bloating, for example, minimal pain. But many people with inflamed gut will feel something. It could be a little bit of pain in one spot, somewhere in the digestive system. It's not uncommon to feel that. And we commonly find bowel to be irregular with inflamed gut. It could be loose sometimes, firm sometimes, inconsistent. Bloating and gas often accompany inflamed gut. These are hallmark signs also of leaky gut syndrome. Nutritional deficiencies, that's number two. They're very, very common with inflamed gut. So if the gut's not functioning properly, you can't basically digest, absorb those nutrients properly. You'll be passing out a lot of good stuff, and that can lead to a lot of signs and symptoms. The deficiencies can be a big problem with inflamed gut, and that can lead to muscle fatigue and brain fog, and just especially fatigue and feeling cranky and not really functioning properly, and immune deficiencies, and many things occur when you don't supply the body with the right nutrition. Poor immune health. We commonly see that one of these signs I look for is secretory IgA in the stool test. So this is an antibody made in the gut at quite a large amount. And we'll often find that that will be very elevated or very depressed. So again, look at my video on SIgA, secretory IgA. I'm sure I've done some videos on that. So that's a good marker to determine, you know, what the immune system is actually doing inside the gut. And most all people I test will have either a very low or a very high IgA. Poor immune health can also reflect in other aspects of immune function in the body. So if you've got a poor gut immune health, it can also lead to poor peripheral immune health, sinus problems, acne, recurring infectious disease, or the skin or urinary tract. It's not uncommon for that to occur too, to have a laboring immune system. Headaches, brain fog, memory loss, these are all common symptoms that we see with inflamed gut. And a big one is excessive fatigue. Very, very tired person. Just too exhausted to do stuff in the afternoon. Too exhausted, getting up in the morning tired, or wanting to lie down on the weekends. So those are some of the signs and symptoms of leaky gut. Hope you found this video useful. Thanks for tuning in.